happened today on this Friday with the oil platform explosion in the Gulf. A federal investigation is now underway to try and figure out what went wrong. Mariner Energy owns that production platform, and this is not Mariner's first time in the spotlight. WDSU reporter Tiffany Bradley joins us now on the phone from the CBD. So what does the company's inspection report say, Tiffany?
Scott, offshore enforcement inspected the Vermilion 380 platform about seven times since 2008, and some of those inspections didn't get a passing grade. The most recent inspection was back in January, where the company Mariner Energy received three violations. Those noncompliances with federal guidelines include an expired first aid kit, inadequate perimeter protection in the heliport, and deteriorated safety litter. But in August 2009, federal inspectors stopped production completely aboard the platform for violations, but the report doesn't say in detail what components of the platform didn't meet federal guidelines. Scott?
Well, will past inspections have any effect on this current investigation?
Well, investigators say right now they're focusing more on what problems occurred yesterday, and past violations won't be considered because during an inspection, if something is wrong, companies are given a number of days to fix the problem.
There are still those reports about oil sheen spotted near that platform. What's the latest on that?
Well, I can tell you that Coast Guard officials spotted the oil sheen near the explosion site in a flyover this morning, but they believe it's oil from the firefighting efforts from yesterday, and it's not oil leaking from the burned platform. Scott.